friends
happened across fair brothers three, who thought they could use all their magic to thwart me. But I, being deaf, being sly, blocked their path and said, brave, cunning brothers, oh, what do you ask? I will give each a prize and then let brothers pass. The first brother begged, please, death, make me a tool, a wand that will win every fight, every duel. So I broke a branch off of an elder tree, and I fashioned a wand, for he thought he was worthy, and gave elder wand to the eldest of three. Go, brother, I bid thee good night. I promise you'll win all your battles and fights, but your wand will be stolen, and you will be slain. Then you and I will meet again. Brother cried, give me magic instead, the power to bring others back from the dead. So I picked up a stone from the riverside, and I told him the pebble had magic inside. It would bring back the dead and his departed bride. Go, brother, I bid thee good night. You'll see love soon, but things will not be right. You'll drive yourself crazy, but she won't be whole, and then I will claim your soul. The youngest brother said, death, I don't trust your ways. Please leave me alone till the end of my days. And though I was reluctant, he was the wisest of the three. So I gave him my cloak of invisibility, and I let the young brother go free. Go, brother, I bid thee good night. Go take your new cloak and go live out your life. Be happy and healthy, and when you are ready, you can take off your cloak and join me. Story of the Peverell brothers. They each made their choice, one wiser than others. They stripped me of a wand and of cloak and of stone, and I bade young Ignatius be selfless and roam. And many years passed till he called me his own. But I took the other two for my own.